Hi, good morning, it's Andrew from ARD. Welcome to the channel. Today we're outside Berry Street Presbyterian, which was built in 1859. That was like 100, no, that was 1,000, no, 3,000. That was like 100,000 years ago. We were asked to put up 5 big TV screens, so I'll take you inside and show you the work. We're in the foyer here of the Berry Street Presbyterian Church. Tim's with me this morning. We're going to put this 65-inch TV. So this is the first unboxing, and we'll lift this up. Let me just come up. We'll not break a TV, promise you. Right, on the back of the TV, there is what's known as a Vista mount, or Visa mount. Is it Visa or Vista? I don't know. 1, 2, 3, 4. That looks like it's about 400 by 400. So this is the Measurematic 27. It's a specially calibrated measuring device. So let's try the smaller ones. 6. I'll do this by finger in case I hit the LCD panel. That seems to be okay. Right, let's get this on. Probably need a washer. Some washers from the washer department. Make sure they're M6 or not. Some washers from here. We're paid by the minute, so every minute counts. Just make sure that's dead on the center. So that goes as far that way, and then goes as far that way, and then we split the difference, which is there. Lovely. So Tim and I are going to try and get this TV, 65-inch TV, up into this bracket, and we'll use the right thing, a chair, and a strategically placed thing. So Tim, I think if we lift this up, just out of the box, first of all, do a big step up onto the chair. Big old lift, so to you slightly. And if we twist it around your way, I got an eye on that, make sure that it's, yeah.
We're in.
That's it, we're good.
Now you can go.
Two bottom screws first, just in case. Twist it your way slightly, and it should bend right now. And then try to get the screw. Half the way of the double. There we go.
Nice one.
Done.
Okay.
Hardly. Don't need that. Don't need that. Wonder if the same remote. There we go.
In the UK, we have these single 13 amp sockets. So this is now a wire outlet. It's called a switch diffused spur with wire outlet. And some mini trunking, which we detest, but that's okay. It's better than a wire hanging loose, and that goes up the back. I'll have to tidy that all up nicely. And that's mounted up on the wall. So whenever the wiring, the extra wiring, there's some Cat 5 here, which will terminate and put one of the Gizmo 43,000 converter on there. That'll do a good job. So this morning we came in and unfortunately there's been an accident. This TV here, which was sitting ready to be installed on the wall next door, had a slight accident. But anywho, that's what happens. So this one's ready to go. It's working nicely. I've had to run some mini trunking around the roof here, which it's detestable, but it's one of the only things that can be done. And then that runs right down here. It goes through the wall and then right the whole way along to the desk at the back. We'll get that terminated and tested later. We were down here in the church last night quite late, and we worked and managed to get these brackets onto the wall. These walls are about 2.5 feet thick, and I think they're made of stone, which has been covered with sawdust, which has then been painted with this cream coloured paint. So as you can see, it's really quite strong. This bracket is in the right place on the wall. It's perfect, it's where it needs to be. From this area, everybody in the church can see the TV. So we're going to go to one of the local stores and get some of that new chemical fixing 5000, which goes in, and after about 2.5 hours, it sets solid. So I'll show you the process behind that. It requires drilling quite a long and probably much larger hole. We'll use some 8mm threaded bar and cut that down to size and have that poking out through. And that means that within a very short time, this will be very solid. Apple headphones.
The air pulses.
I originally drilled these here with a 6mm masonry drill bit, SDS, and as I said earlier in the video, this wall is made of probably 200 year old stone, and in behind here is sawdust. It feels hard, but it's not, because the top three, and the bottom one came out. So I'm going to jump in here with the big drill bit. If I can find it. If somebody hasn't already come in here and nicked it. Oh, what have I done with the drill bit? No, like, seriously. You see, when you persevere, you find it lying somewhere completely different. It's not switched on yet. The reason I haven't done this one here is because it was actually quite good. It's into stone. So we'll use this existing, I think it's 4-inch Thunderbolt, which gives us one good fixing into stone, and then the rest will be done with the chemical compound. It's it's very important to hoover out the holes because the dust that's in there will actually trap. It's also very important that when you switch on a hoover, that you hoover yourself. And then we'll check. That's good. That's good. Excellent. I like to use Roll Plug R-Chem. It's the best. In here, there is a black substance and a sort of an probably orangey-yellowy substance. And they come out and mix in this tube. It says in the instructions that you should actually do 10 centimetres, which is 4 inches, before. And the bit that I did upstairs, I come back to the 10 centimetres and right enough, the first few inches of it was absolutely rubbish. So they're 10 centimetres. Remind me not to put my finger in that. Put a lot extra into the top one because the last thing we want this to do is to fall down, and I might actually go in and put more in that one. I'll probably end up using the entire tube, but I'd rather do that than have a television fall on somebody. Out now. Such a good feeling. Yeah, that needs more. Look, that's only in by a little blob. Must be an airline version of that, which would be so much easier. I'm going to get some more. I've successfully managed to get the bolts, which have now set after a couple of hours, in and tight. And the last one to do then is just this one here, which is this thunderbolt, which was tight earlier. Solid. You could hang on it. Good job. Now the easy bit, of course, is to somehow glue the TVs onto the wall, and that's the bit which takes probably the most mechanical effort. And obviously the safety element of that is very important, because if it falls and kills somebody, that's never good. The wiring part of it then is the next part. And so basically it starts here in this corner where the sound desk is going to be. And I think that I'll just run a wire from here directly across the top of the pews to each TV. The alternative, of course, is to run some wires along this existing trunking and then come up with some new trunking all the way to the ceiling and then cut across. And I've opened up
the ceiling at this point. And the ceiling then will take me through and up to the balcony. And I'll see you up there because I want to show you that.
In the balcony, and we have this lovely curved balcony. I'm going to put one of the 75-inch TVs at that blue wall, and we'll run some trunking right round at foot level or skirting board level, and do the other TV at the other side. I'm out of breath because I come up the stairs too quickly. And approximately at this position here, we should be able to pick up the ceiling that we opened underneath. One of the most difficult things about an installation like this is the fact that there are pillars everywhere. Pillars are really useful because they help to hold the roof up. And without them, the roof would fall down and that wouldn't be good. But the problem with having so many pillars is that no matter where you sit, there's a pillar in the way. So what I want to do now is to jump downstairs and try and pick up where this board comes through and see if there's a way of drilling a very neat and careful hole down through this skirting. Oh, hello. Well, I've managed to get on all of this trunking the whole way round. All the way round. And here, it's a bit messy at the minute, but it'll be okay when the lid goes on. There's three holes there for the power lead and the signal lead to come down. I've checked the size of the trunking and it will take three cats, which means a TV there and a TV underneath, and a return from the stage for a laptop, and then the same on the other side, plus a power lead and a power lead. So that gets everything nice and neat. Next thing to do is to pull some cable through. Oh goody. The surface in this wall is actually been made with plasterboard, and there's probably stone in behind that. So we're going to drill quite deep and then use some chemical fixing to put the threaded rods. So we've actually got these threaded rods that we've just cut. I think you saw me cut them. And the drill bit has been marked piece of yellow tape, and that's how far in I should drill to allow it to stick out about an inch. Should be enough. So Tim's away to get the Hoover, and we don't want to make dust. We'll do the right thing and clean up as we go along. Aye. Oh, that is so good.
Thick down to it.
Yep. I've just put these bolts in and the chemical fastener is still wet, which means there's a little bit of time until they go solid, and I can put this bracket on and put a spirit level on it, and then just tape it to the wall whenever. We'll probably leave this overnight, even though it does say that it's set within a couple of hours. I don't trust it. I don't trust anything. Hard to do with one hand. Oh, come on. So final bracket's about to go up, which is great news. I've made the hole slightly bigger on it because the didn't line up perfectly. This is the alignment tool 3400. I like that tool, it works really well. All I have to do now is put a bit of a washer on that and it'll be perfect. Of course I'm going to wipe off the excess of that stuff, don't be silly. Finally, a bracket into a wall which is made of sawdust and it's been painted over. Stone which is probably 200 years old, dear knows how long before that. And that bracket is good for 75 inch TV. There's also one on the other side. There it is. All that will be hidden, of course, by the TV. There it is, ready to go up. Just managed to get the ceiling apart here at this point and I've put it back together again. So you missed that bit, but not to worry. So the cables come down from upstairs on the mini trunking. They come down through the holes that we drilled and they go along here, and then I've added this new piece of trunking
we'll have to do a little bit of decorator's mate at that bit there. And it comes down to here. So this is our 5 cat cables, one per screen, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we're doing a return video over cat, and we've also put some power in there as well. So that's all gonna be pulled in here.
I just drilled a little inspection hole down here in the corner. We've got to put a box here to split this electrical cable. One will go up and one will go down downstairs. So let's go downstairs and see if we can pick that up.
Upstairs, the hole I've drilled I think is about a foot in from this edge. So if I put a hole here, and I can put a piece of trunking down to the TV, let's see where we go with this. If in doubt, poke it with something orange. That is further up than it looks.
If orange is not long enough, join another orange to the first orange.
Please be there when I go up. So this one is what we would say here in Northern Ireland, being a little bit thran. I've drilled a bigger hole in below the carpet here, and I can actually see, I can see down into the hole below. So rather than waste any more time, because it's below the carpet, and because this box here can go, we'll just continue this hole further along. We'll just brush that dust in there. Nobody will see it. That's perfect. So the orange rod, I can now see down to the hole, which is covered in dust. That's it down through. Oh, brilliant. That's it right down through.
Gotta check in case it's on. Get in there. Come on, just get in there. That'll do. Of course I've got a plastic lid to go on it. And of course I haven't brought it up with me. What's wrong with you?
So I finally managed to get the trunking on the wall and I got the cables through in the four TVs, so I'm so pleased that we're that far on. So now we're going to stick on four of these double socket outlets. And of course thoroughly test them, and then we will do the Cat5s, test them, and then it's time to get the TVs on the wall and get this project wrapped up. These screws are probably going to fall out. Maybe.
Well, good morning, it's Monday and we're back here in Berry Street Presbyterian in Belfast. Now, we finished off very late on Friday night and I was exhausted, but we've had a weekend of sleep and refreshed, ready to go. It's the morning here, sun is shining, the weather's lovely here in Northern Ireland, and we're going to get cracking today. So first thing to do is to make sure that all the cables are nice and neatly untied from this pile. And over here there's a load of cable which is run up to each TV, and so there should be five, plus I've done a little surprise, which is a return from the stage. One of the lines here on the stage returns, comes back down to the back here, which means they can run a laptop then from the stage. So that's a little bit of a little extra. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take these here and chop them off at a certain length and terminate, and that'll get us started. Underneath this pew here, I'm going to mount a few of the converter units that convert HDMI over Cat5, and we'll get them all mounted underneath, so we'll show you that. I think I'll just chop them all off at this length here, and they can be taped up. Cat5 is a very versatile cable. It's designed to be used for data, and really it can be analog audio, digital audio, it can be video, HDMI over Cat. It's Cat5e and it's very, very good. So what I like to do is separate out the pairs, put the orange that side, the brown this side, and the green and blue just over. A couple of twists open the twist, and it's the twist that's in the pair that means that it can carry the data at the frequency and for the distance. And I just stick a screwdriver in, very gently pull the pairs apart. If I could find the thing, there we go. Finally here. Can do most Cat5s in under a minute, but whenever you're videoing, of course, it's never the same. So white of orange, orange, white of green, blue, white of blue, green, white of brown, brown. Straighten those up nicely, hold them tight, and then this tool here has got this little cutter built in,
just insert, squeeze, it cuts, grab a connector, and insert the connector. So white of orange, orange, white of green, blue, white of blue, green, white of brown, brown. Push that in there. Push nice and hard, and then squeeze. I like to squeeze three times. And that's it done. So the next thing to do in the grand scheme of things, I realise that I say so a lot. So we're going to have to we twist here. Maybe we'll make it a bit longer. Might be all right. Such a good tool. And then we'll use the cutters to peel off a little bit of the outer. We'll make the blue a tiny bit shorter. And the brown a bit shorter again. A wee twist. Now it's very important that the twist is clockwise. Otherwise everything goes wrong. The whole rest of the day, nothing goes right. It's like the water in the plug hole. So put that there. Open the plug. Now this has been set to 13 amp. And there's no way that four TVs are going to draw 13 amps. So we'll take that fuse out and swap it for a 3. Because each TV is 170 watts, which is about half an amp here in the UK. 110 volts, that would be just over an amp, but in the UK it's a 240 volt supply. It's actually 230 now because of the harmonised European regulation. So 230 volts, 170 watts is half an amp, times 4 is 2 amps. So a 3 amp fuse is perfect. I like to start with the earth and then rotate towards the neutral and then finally bring the live connector in. Now the reason for making the live short is that if the cable gets tugged, the live will come out. The earth is long enough to still be connected, which means the equipment will be disconnected and it won't cause an electrocution. And then finally we put this earth clamp, sorry, I keep calling it an earth clamp, but it actually is the whole cable strain relief. Come on. Tighten that one down as well. And you don't have to go severely tight. You don't have to break your wrist. As long as it's tight enough that it doesn't pull. What we then do is what's known as spannering. Spanner every connection. 1, 2, 3. And that's it done. I'll come back and change the fuse, but for now that's that done. I've got this strip here of plastic. It's actually cable tray, and I'm going to use that for mounting all these nice bits of hardware. So I can mount it underneath the pew, because there's 5 of these things here to go on. So the first thing to do is to get them all open. So we want the one that says transmit in each case. Transmit. Receive. You can do no wrong. But you can snatch my hat, tease my cat, frown and pout and bore me out, rip my toes and punch my nose, give me a checkers and dominoes, a kiss me too and hold me tight. Everything you do's alright. Baby, baby, you can do no wrong. Wrong.
make me get down on my knees. But baby, baby, you can do no wrong. Take me off and stretch it out. Stretch your name on my Cadillac. Baby, baby, you can do no wrong.
The idea behind this is that the incoming cable from the laptop Pro Presenter comes into this first box, and then it'll go out from this to the here, and then to the rear TV, and then this splitter will split into the 1, 2, 3, 4 TVs here on the front wall. So we'll get some of these here open.
Snatch my hat, tease my cat, frown and pout and pour me out. Rip my clothes and punch my nose, cheat me checkers and dominoes. Kiss me too and hold me tight, everything you do's alright. Baby, baby, you can do no wrong.
In order to power all of the TVs and all of these, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 items that need power. We'll use two of these mains strips. So there's 1, 2, and we'll get them open up and powered nicely. I've got this special box, which is really, really good because it's got all these exciting little Lego bricks in them. If you've not met a Wago connector, they are a game changer. Here in the UK, we have these things called block connectors, and I don't think there's going to be very many block connectors sold now going forward, because these things are absolutely superb.
rated at 30 amps. I always like to check by pulling each wire to make sure that it's well and truly secured and not about to fall out, like that one for example. Good. Get in there. I've got this device called the Buzzit 5000, which when you plug into a electrical outlet, buzzes. There we go. So before we do any connection, it's important to check and make sure that the Buzzit 5000 buzzes. Anything that's wrong will show up with these bright orange LEDs. The last bit of the jigsaw puzzle then is each of these boxes needs powered, and they have supplied us with these lovely power leads which go in here at the back. So I think the furthest away ones will probably need to be, might be able to keep that little tag on. Nope. That pleases me. I'm happy now.
I've successfully managed to put the board underneath here. I don't know if you can see it in the dark. I've plugged it in.
So we'll go up to stage with our little blue buzzer 2400 or whatever model number it is. Now that these are all done, check and see. That's good. Yep, obviously. That's another good one. Just to show you that's the trunking now, nice and neat, the whole way. So there's 10 lengths of 3 metres, that's 30 feet. No, 90 feet, or about 30 metres, 100 feet in old money. Or American money. I don't know. And let's try this mains power thing here. And that's good as well. So that's all four powers, in fact all five powers tested. I've got my Test-O-Matic 5002, which is a cable tester for RJ45s. So we'll plug them in there. And that puts a sequence up the cable. And then at this end here, there should be one of these. I don't know which one it is yet, so let's have a look. One of these will register right away. Obviously not that one. 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 Well, that's just strange. No, hold on. Oh yes, that's right, I put yellow tape on the one that I did at the back. So it should count from 1 to 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yay! That's good. Now, first TV on in the church. Not that one. Not that one. Not that one. See, you could label these as you're doing it, but why do that? There we go. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Perfect. Not that one. 1, 2. Oh, we're missing 3. We're missing 1. There's what happens when it doesn't work.
white of orange, orange, white of green, blue, white of blue, green, white of brown, brown, white of green. So the thing is, you don't know which end is wrong. Could be this end, could be that end. The first thing to do is to try another squeeze. So let's get the squeezer. No three. Check very carefully. White of orange, orange, white of green. Looks like it's the whole way up. So what I'll do this time is leave this one plugged in and go up to the other side. And it'll say if it's right up there as well. So this is the perfect example. At least we know that this is number four. So we'll just mark it as a four. One, two, three. They also do Sharpies in black, you know. But what is it about Sharpies? You can never have a Sharpie when you need one. I buy them now by the dozen every time I see them and they just disappear. So, yeah, back upstairs. I am going to be so fit by the end of this. Ba-da-bum-bum-ba-da-bum. No, I don't fall over the hedge. So, if you can see here, it's not got a three at this end either. And this is just typical of a day in the life of an AV installer. There it is now. So it just needs another squeeze. Now that could be that this thing here has got wet and it does rain a lot here in Northern Ireland. No, it's okay, the copper's all the way to the end of it. I'm gonna go with that it was not inserted properly. Let's just keep it, give it a wiggle. It seems to be okay now. Happy with that. Next, we're gonna go ahead here and do the right thing and pull all these cables down behind this rear pew. Come on now, stop it. So the only one we're not going to plug in just now is the one with no number on it. And the furthest away one from earlier on is the first DA. No number is this one. Neat. Which side is the arm? It's always the other side, isn't it? So HDMI 1 box. Now does this need power at this end? I do not know. Probably because it's junk. Yeah. Oh. And that's why we've got a double power thing. Because it's just as easy to wire up a double as it is a single. And I didn't know whether it needed the power supply at this end, which clearly does. And this should now burst into life. And it should light up and flash, which it does, which is amazing. And then we'll get the remote for the TV if somebody has stolen it. And boom. And then we'll put it onto HDMI 1. Do you want to switch the screen of the connected device? Yes.
How very polite and mannerly. Check transmission input signal. Okay, let's get a laptop.
So the only other hurdle there might be here is the two-way splitter may need power, and that could be a nuisance. HDMI out. Look away now. In case you would break into my warehouse. Underneath again, into the mighty input of the first unit. Why do they all make these things bigger? No. Get back now, come on you monster. Right. Will it work? I don't know. Does it need power? This unit here probably needs power. Well, I'll be dipped. It needs power. That's why I have one spare socket. Let's get some power. I can't see again, hold on. Maybe that drawer actually does something. That's amazing. Okay. Then, what's this asking? I thought I'd just put the password in. What is wrong with you? There we go. Why did it just reboot? What? Macs have a life of their own. Yay. Screen. Have you detected a screen? Arrangement. Identify. I don't know how to do this. What's going on here? Arrangement. We'll move that one to that side. Although I don't know why people do that. Why not do it there? And then all you got to do is push your mouse up. So you should hopefully see that or similar out here. I am genuinely impressed. I am invincible. Yay. Well, that's one. We'll have to come back and tidy this mess up, but that's all right. It works. It's alive. And if we take the power lead out, it stops. So power supplies on all ends. We mustn't use power over Ethernet on the wire. So the white of orange on the white of green, and the orange and green are the ones that have been used. The blues and browns are not been used. So if the blues or browns had a failure there, it would still work. But we like to be thorough, so that's very good. That's complete. I'll just have to tidy that, which I'll just okay.
That's it.
And then we'll get the spanner on it.
Don't let go of this yet.
No. Why are we both out of breath?
That's out of COVID, mate. But I'm out of breath because my nerves.
I got my nerves are wrecked. I'm having to hold my belly in because of the camera. You always know when you're on the home straight when you're putting the batteries in.
Fiddly jobs.
And of course then it's going to ask you all the questions. At least they didn't break that one.
One down, four to go. I haven't broken any of them.
I've never broken a
a screen.
I couldn't believe that.
Oh, just such bad luck. We've now got two TVs working in the room. Yay! And a happy client. And the one at the back's working. So it's into a fourth day, and tomorrow morning we'll do the ones up there. So one of the last things I'm going to do today up here is to cut off these long bolts. Now, before we use any kind of power tools, please be sure to read, follow and understand any instructions. Also make sure that you wear safety glasses, and I like to use hearing protection. Now, it doesn't have to be Bose, but that's okay. It is noise cancelling and it's very good. So let's turn this here so that it's straight on. Let's grind. Come on.
And then just hold it like that, I'll get the mains cable. I'm not used to touching my hand, okay? That's okay.
You got it, Weaver,
didn't you? I've got it. On my side. Okay. I'll do the same. So you've got it.
Yep.
Right, big lift. Super.
Hey, 1 second. Oh, flip me.
Big old lift.
Hang on.
That's it.
Think I'm in, are you?
Yep.
Yeah? Oh, that's nerve wracking that.
That's it. Is it on?
Oh dear.
Yeah, no, there's so little room to work here, but.
Aye, getting this.
Wait a minute, I'll move the chair on. Just well, we've sort of got a hand on it. Well, sort of got it. Should slide. Slightly. Ooh. Yep. Yeah. Which means that it's on both hooks. Otherwise, it wouldn't slide.
You can actually get it out slightly.
Oh! You're okay.
But.
Sorry.
Oh!
You're okay.
Oh!
You're okay.
Oh!
You're okay.
But.
I'm right up at it, so it's really noisy for me.
The last bit of putting this big TV up now is going to wire up. So I've managed to get the HDMI lead in already. And I've got my trusty ladder with me here, which is great. So we'll go up the ladder. I like to work from above the TV. So with one hand on the ladder, one hand on the phone, and one hand on the... Oh right, that's right, I haven't got any more hands. I'll put that up here. Now, what's it asking me? Press the OK button stroke wheel on your remote. Oh, what's that? That one. Here we go. Yes, it's a TV. English. What is all these questions? I don't need questions. Exit first time use. Yes, I'm sure. Well, I think it's this one at the top that changes the input source to the HDMI lead. So press it. Press it again. Press it again. And hit the enter button. Boom. And the final stage, which is the best bit of it all, is this nice piece of plastic here at the bottom. Oh, the feeling of that is just unbelievable. It's like opening an Apple iPhone for the first time.
Well, that's it for this project today. We've been here now for 4 days and we've finally managed to get the job complete. 4 75-inch TVs up on the walls behind me, as you can see, 2 in the balcony and 2 underneath, and 1 behind in the foyer. It's been a long one, but thanks so much for joining us today.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Amazon Basics, some of the best batteries that money can't buy. Such excitement. We've got one bar. I bet that it'll go to zero bars in like no time. One extra little bit just for your attention here is the sound side of this thing. Now, I've not touched it. All I've done, it was this way around when I came in. I've moved it to here because I think that's probably better use of the space. It is, of course it's better use of the space. Everybody say yes, Andrew. So, here there's that so thing again. I keep saying so. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Let's put a bit of gain into this, see what it sounds like. Sensitivity, neg 30. Let's try neg 10. Unless they're a real shouter, neg 20 is probably. Yeah, 10. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. No, need more than that. Let's do neg 18.
Right, okay, yeah, there's lots of stuff that needs to go
there. Hey, 1, 2, 1, 2. So it's either tie or this one. 1, 2, 1, 2. Lovely. Mute. Who uses mute? What is wrong with people? 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, there's an air gap somewhere. What's not switched on? Here we go. Sounds like a Hoover. 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. That's still amazing. So it's going to mix. Church mix. 2, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. One, two, one, two. Now I'm confused. Oh, it's easy to confuse me then. So these two are definitely going down into that amp. And it's definitely going, unless the speakers are absolutely blown into smithereens, who knows? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. It might be coming off the mono. Do that, so 1, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. 1, 2, 2, 2. It's not often that a sound desk gets me, but this one certainly isn't working. Left, right. It's going to left, right. It's not muted. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. I can see levels on the thing. I detest analog desks. They're detestable.
Right, what's going on here? Stereo. Sensitivity. I bet you he didn't plug them in properly at the speaker.
Ah, oh, thank you so much. Look at that, it's coffee!
I don't think
you plugged the speakers in properly. Now, with the speak on, you have to twist it. See, it needs to be pushed in as well as twisted. So, I just think he's pushed them in. And twist. There we go now, that's what's wrong. Easy mistake. Try not to spill my coffee, but I am spilling it everywhere. This one's not gonna be done either. Look, it's sitting out. There we go. Rookie mistake. Mitch, what's wrong with you? Hey, yeah. Listen, it's not wrong. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. That works.